Good afternoon, everyone. Today we are going to talk about that what could be assisted or what can be taken out of the customer value management course, along with the case study provided about the AnswerDesk company. So the company has been providing services to different other companies that are trying to find a reliable solution so that the customers are self-oriented and self-sufficient to solve their problems and queries. There has been really, really intriguing facts that could be taken on from the theory of customer value management. In fact, the main process or the main factor for any company is to create value. So for a firm to create value, it has to take some substantial moves in order to understand their customers and to provide them with the services that they'll be willing to pay more and more in order to generate the profits. So the first fact would be to understand the customer, the CRM strategy for the company or the customer relationship management for the company. Although for AnswerDesk, we could understand that yes, they did not decide on a very good customer base because they were not able to target their potential customers, but they really need to focus upon the customers that they'll be focusing upon. Also, they were going with their professional networks, which is itself a not a good strategy on the long term to create value with the share for the shareholders, because eventually they would definitely run out of the networks that they have known professionally. The next, they need to understand the size of wallet for their customers so that they can estimate and provide a better packages for their customers and also be profitable at the same time. The next is they need to move away from silo thinking, and they need to be cross-functional in between the departments for a better customer relationship management and also to be better at organizing and generating benefits with monetary values. The next which comes is the customer-driven pricing strategy needs to be developed. So the strategy which is not only focused upon what they are offering or in comparison to their competitors, but also about what their customers are basically looking up for towards the company, so that it would be something that is provided with the value, with the worthiness of that product. Also, the pricing model can also be looked upon with the degrees of differentiation or discrimination. So the first degree of discrimination can be definitely used with the versioning method, because they have been providing basic, pro, and advanced version to the companies, which itself is a good strategy, so that the companies which may be small, medium, or large enterprises can utilize the different versions according to their use and their needs. Also, they need to develop a pricing strategy also on these basis, that how the companies are going to use them, because each pricing and each worthiness is different to everyone. And also, the pricing of any product is also very much incoherent or perceived as a good quality or a better quality with that product. That is why people often buy Apple phones when it's like approximately $1,000, and they perceive it to be of a good value. Whereas if Samsung comes up with something which is of $500 and provide exactly same what Apple has been providing, it will be something that people consider that it is of cheaper quality. And on the final note, I would say that pricing, maybe price war is not the right strategy for the company, but discount allocation on the basis of maybe annual or like more better subscription plans can be done for the company to reach on more and more target. In the end, I would like to say that pricing lifecycle needs to be taken into consideration because of innovating, growth, and maturity and decline. All these are a process of complete pricing lifecycle. And hence, the company needs to keep innovating. Then they are going to see the growth and become mature and see the decline. And if they'll be innovating again, the process goes on. Hence, the company needs to focus upon this, and this cycle will go on. Thank you so much for your time and anticipation.